something that you offer to God when you really don't what feel up to it. You're never to give in to the way you feel regardless of how, amen, you come tired, you come overwhelmed, you come distressed, and you come sick, you come with problems. You're never to be governed by the way you feel. All right, if you are being governed by the way you feel, if how you feel or the mood that you're in will dictate the degree that you'll praise the Lord, that means you're being motivated by your what? Flesh. And the Bible says they that are in the flesh cannot do what? Please God. Now all of this stuff, see, I first started with y'all about pride of what? Pride of face, pride of pace, pride of place, pride of race, and the last one, pride of grace. See, pride of grace is what I'm speaking about now. We feel that we can praise the Lord the way we want to. See, humility, the Bible says God resists the proud, but he gives what? Grace to the humble. Humble is a person that retires from their own way and they what? Yield to God's way. They retire from their way. See, your way would say, I don't feel like praising the Lord. You ain't got to do all that. You don't have to open your mouth wide. You didn't have to offer no sacrifice. Sacrifice means that you are doing whether you feel like it or not, but sacrifice goes further than that. The sacrifice that we're to offer to God continually, that is the fruit of our lips, that is giving thanks to his name. This is what that actually means in Hebrews 13:15. It means that you praise the Lord for everything that you are believing him to do for you. Everything that you are believing him to do, amen, doing the prayers, or if you're offering prayers, how many still pray every day? How many do a little bit more playing than praying? Y'all know it's a difference between playing and what? Praying. Now everybody ought to be praying in the spirit every day. Amen. Scripture says, be careful for nothing. Be worried or disturbed, distracted by nothing, but in everything by what? Prayer and what? Thanksgiving, let your requests be made known. And the peace of God, which passes all understanding, will keep your hearts and minds in perfect peace. That means with every prayer, everybody say, with every prayer you pray. Say it again, with every prayer you pray, if you're praying, you're to offer up what? Thanksgiving after you pray, or even before you pray. Offer what? Thanksgiving. Amen. Now, thanksgiving is to be offered with every prayer because thanksgiving is what we call the sacrifice that you offer up before you receive the thing that you are believing for. You praise the Lord for what you are believing him to do, for whatever you are asking him to do. So you don't want to pray a prayer and don't offer thanksgiving, because thanksgiving, Wednesday night we learned that thanksgiving is the thing that you do in order to what? To get your faith at a level where God can what? He can what? He can respond to that prayer. Now remember, Sister Hill brought it out, Brother Holman, you missed it Wednesday night. Brother Holman had a revelation. And Sister Hill piggybacked on it. It was powerful. Okay, Sister Hill, Brother Holman brought it all up about how Jehoshaphat and all of these men, they got their victory through what? Praising. Okay, but Jehoshaphat was surrounded by three nations that had come to eat their lunch. They came to destroy them, wipe them out. Jehoshaphat didn't have a clue as to what to do in order to get the victory. They were outnumbered many times, 3-1, 10-1. It was a huge multitude that had surrounded Israel round about, and they had come to cast them out of their inheritance. And the Bible says Jehoshaphat got very scared. Amen. Very scared. And in that story, we went over the things that Jehoshaphat and his army had to do in order to get rid of the fear, because see, God cannot work in an atmosphere where there is what? There's fear. It's got to be an atmosphere of what? Faith. But what do you do when you're scared? You believe in God for stuff, and you're scared. I mean, you're just scared. You don't know whether God is going to do it or not. I'm not even know whether I'm in faith. I don't know if I have a capability of getting this thing, what, amen, actually, done. What do you do? What did Jehoshaphat do? Jehoshaphat got his people to seek the Lord. He got them all fasting and praying. Amen. So y'all know what fasting and praying does. That humbles the soul. Amen. God resists the proud, but he gives what? Grace to the humble. Whatever you can do to humble your soul, that's the thing that's going to help you to get in a position to see God work. And God eliminate whatever challenge or whatever problem, whatever's confronting you, that's the way you deal with it. So we concluded Wednesday night that whenever you are praying and you're asking God, you're making supplications, or you're praying the word, then there's another element that needs to be. Sometimes fasting needs to be what offered up with what? Prayer. There are certain things you're not going to get victory over until you what? You fast. Your appetite got to come under what? Control, so the things of God can what? Rise up. See, many times our flesh is way up here, and our desire for God is what? Our anointing and the faith thing is way down here. Amen. Especially if you are negligent in your Bible studies and praying in the Spirit and things of that nature, you'll find that your flesh is going to what? Run crazy. Amen. So, fasting helps to humble the soul. God resists the proud, but he gives grace to the what? He gives grace to the humble. And God said, I dwell among